Hi, this is Jay Pomelo Art, and today I am going to show you guys how to draw and paint a deckhead moth.
I'm going to start by painting it, and this one I'm just going to add shadow and leave the whole background white.
Now that we're finished our drawing,
the next step that we will do is creating a yellow.
I'm going to take some of this cadmium yellow, medium. I'm going to mix them together. A little more of this cadmium yellow. And then wet the entire thing with water. Minus the antenna and the legs. And I'm going to float that yellow color as my base color. Because of watercolor, you always want to work lightest to darkest. And the reason you always want to work light to dark is because watercolor is transparent. So you can build color using washes. So let's say you wanted to make a purple, but you didn't have a purple. You could do a wash of red as a base and then add some blue on top, and the combination would make a purple layer. So if you add dark, you can't add light over top of that. It just wouldn't show through, or it would look way too washed out. Which is why I don't personally like using the white, like the watercolor white, which is like a Chinese white, because I find that it always looks way too washed out. And now I'm going to float on my yellow color. So I'm going to do it near the edges, where I want it to be darkest, and then taking a wet paintbrush that I lightly dab up, I'm going to push the color into the center, because I'm looking for this lighter color. Lighter yellow, especially in the lower part of the wings, in these second set of wings. To be a little wetter than that. There we go. I'm looking for like a pale yellow in this area. Wash dry. I'm going to take some of this yellow again, and I'm going to darken up certain areas where it would be like more shadowy. So I'm going to go here. And for this one, I want to create a gradient effect. So I'm going to pull the color, because I don't want a harsh line. I want to soften it up. So right now
there's that harsh line of stop, so I'm going to take a wet brush and I'm just going to pop it. And it softens up that line real nicely. Now I'm just darkening up certain areas to give it like a shadowy look. So my goal is to make it look like the wings kind of have they're not straight across, they've got like more of a ripple to them. And in the low spots, the color would be slightly darker. And I don't want to create a harsh edge, so I am adding color and then softening the edges of it. And then the tips in these areas, I want to be an even darker yellow, and over here. So I'm just going to take full out yellow ochre, just yellow ochre, and add those on top. Brush and clean it. Alright, so the wings are nice and vibrant, but now I want this area, this like skull area of the death head moth, to be more of a gray yellow. So I'm going to mix a new color. I'm going to take my yellow ochre, and I'm just going to put it where I put my yellow ochre last time. But instead, this time, I am going to take a blue. I'm going to mix it together. Creates this ashy yellow. Perfect. That's the color I'm looking for. now I'm going to take that and pop in this thing. I'm first actually going to lift off the color underneath it, and you can do that because it is wet. So I'm going to take my paper towel. I'm just going to scrub at it with a stiffer brush and then dab up. And it's lifting off some of that color because it was too vibrant of a yellow for me. Now that that's lifted off, then I can go in with the more ashy color. Perfect. This is perfect. And I want this color to be present in the wings as well. Or down here. And then I want to make some of the shading this color as well. So now that I have my color down, I'm going to take a wet brush and I'm going to spread that around so that it's not so concentrated. And near the edges, I'm going to do that fade in. There. Perfect. So I'm going to do that to this side. And this side has already dried, but you can see if you have high quality paper, you can just re-wet it and move it around again. Or it creates these cool looking effects. I'm really happy with that, so I'm just going to leave that. And I'm going to add it near the tips here as well. And now I'm going to dry this section. Okay, so now that we have our yellow bases going, we are going to start layering on those dark layers. So we're going to mix a nice deep brown. So we're going to take our burnt umber, perfect, and then we're going to mix it with blue. Take more of this blue. Because we're looking for more of like a gray brown. Not so much one with red in it, but one with a lot of blue in it. This looks about the right color. Maybe a little bit more blue. Okay, this I'm happy with. All right. So now that we have that color, I'm going to keep this loaded up because this is already nice and loaded up with paint. And I'm going to start wetting down specifically the areas where I want to float this color on. So I'm going to start working with the head. I want the entire head covered. And I'm going into this middle bit. I believe there's the thorax? I don't know what parts. And then I'm going to go around this bow, this skull shape. While lifting it, I got rid of quite a bit of the pencil marks, so I am kind of just playing a guessing game here. that's enough. So I'm just going to glue them on, like so. Perfect. Now when this gets a little more dry, I'm going to start like softening the edges, but I don't want to do it right now because it's too wet and we're working really dark, so I don't want to do anything to really disturb it. So I'm going to leave it like this, and then I'm going to start doing the same process to the butt part, which I believe is in the forest, but again, don't quote me, I am not a book expert. So we're going to use that wet-on-wet technique. And as you can see, because I touched up here, now the dark color is bleeding into the rest of it. Which is what we want to have at this point. This part looks fluffy, so I'm not being super crisp and clean with my lines in between each of these spots of yellow, but we're going to go in anyways and make it fluffier. Perfect. I love that for the first blush. Now I'm going to add more texture to these. But they look very textured, and they have these wavy lines through them. So I'm just dry brushing that. And I'm going to layer it. So that's what I'm doing here. This is called a dry brush technique. It's when your paper is dry. As you can see, none of it, it's not bleeding like down here was. So this is specifically what I'm looking for. And this is just the first layer, so. Some of this I do want to pull, so like right here, I want to make these edges more interesting. I like what's happening here underneath. There we go. So because watercolor is transparent, then when I add another layer on top of this, you're going to be able to see some of these darker spots underneath. And the last one is going to be down here. And then we're just going to continuously darken it all. This next part is lighter. So I'm actually going to wet this because this part is less defined. So I kind of want this light, bleak look. Alright, now we're going to do the second part, the second one. So I'm going to take this nice thin brush again. I'm going to do exactly what I did last time. It's a little too much color, so I want less color on the brush. This part over here. All right, now I'm going to start working on these top wings a little bit better. So I'm going to wet the whole thing. I'm gonna wet both sides actually. Just realizing there's this part right here that I don't want to wet. So I'm just gonna towel that up. There we go. Again, I'm gonna take this and I wanna create some fun. Just water spots. So I'm just going to really dab and let the paint kind of like dry its spots. Because when you look at its patterns, especially on these top wings, it's very patchy. So I'm going to take that. I am actually going to dry it so it doesn't bleed. I'm going to dry it so it doesn't bleed too much. Now that it's like more halfway dry, I'm going to just add in some spots myself. Now it looks like there is some red, so I'm going to take my burnt sienna and just create its own color area. I'm going to take that and add some highlights. it's drying, I'm going to mix more of my brown. Now I'm going to start adding in some detail. So it looks like the edge of this part is darker. This is where we're going to start looking at making the furrow more fluffy. So I'm just going to create tiny little lines to fill it in. I'm going to make some of these details less defined. So I'm going to use a lifting technique. Now I'm going to add more texture to these wings. So I'm kind of just working from like body part to body part, building up texture. Because you don't want to, there's an area that's wet, like these wings, I want to wait until they dry before I add on the new layer. So this one, I'm going to add more detail. Like the middle parts have a little more depth to them. So I'm adding darker lines in between. Brush for this. Thank you. So now I'm going to take my angle brush. And I want these areas right here in the wings to be lighter than this. So I'm going to go in and I'm going to lift out some of this color. Actually, I want a different brush for this. I'm using this brush, which is really good for lifting out. And I'm lifting out so that it's not all uniform. So I'm going to continue layering on this dark color that I've created. So the brown part. Body part more of a rounded shape. So I'm going to cover the entire thing because I'm going to sweep out these two. And then I'm going to wet my paintbrush again, dry it off so that it's damp. And then I'm going to go in and I'm going to pick up paint in the middle. And that will give me more of like a rounded shape to it. And I'm going to do that around the middle part of the body as well. But I'm going to change my brush. And these dark parts right here, I want to take the brush leaves and I want to feather the edges so they're not such harsh lines. Again, it gives it more of a three-dimensional look instead of just 2D. Now I'm going to darken these wings. So the wings of the death head moth, although like the top wings are very dark, it still looks like there's almost a strata running through them and the lines made in rock that you see. So I'm going to actually layer on some of that. Okay, now I'm going to let that dry. I want this edge really dark. Alright, now that that's drying, I'm going to return back to the bottom half, and I want the yellow to look more feathery. So we are going to do that by grabbing a brush with a very fine tip. I'm using this one. I'm going to pick up the bright yellow, not the slate or gray yellow that we created, the bright yellow. And go in and just add to the box. Specifically over here on this box, but I am not a bug expert, so don't quote me on that. And I'm going to grab the brownish red that we used earlier, which is kind of completely white. That to be a little darker, so that a little more just kind of fun. There we go. Great. You want to make more of a textured look up here though, so that will come in a bit. Now I'm going to continue layering on the dark color on this. What I'm calling the 4X area. So I'm going to continue doing little tiny strokes. I want to dry brush it right now. My brush is a little too wet. Thank you. today is more about layering detail, because now you have the majority of all the details, so you have the big things. So at this point, I'm just going to continue to layer on detail. So I'm going to use the panels to give this more of a texture, which means that I'm just going to use dots. Closer together the dots, the darker the because I've wet that area down, lifted it up and maybe brush for a bit, so I'm going to have to return back to that until it's completely dry, because otherwise it's going to start bleeding. These two wings are dry. I'm actually going to lift out a little bit here and there. So I'm going to wet my coarser brush, dab it again. And then I'm just going to move around, create some texture. This part right here. And then, as it's still wet, I'm gonna dab it up. You can also use a script brush for this part. Let me grab one. Show you. This area right here is super cool. So I'm going to load up this brush with a lot of yellow. The antenna up here. So they actually have the tips of their antenna. So I'm trying to create the illusion of that. And here's the light sticking out. Here's the light sticking out. So I'm gonna try this. And then my last step is going to be to create a shadow. For the most part, this is dry, so now I'm gonna want to create a shadow. So I want to mix in a green. So I'm gonna take this blue. So there's a round into it. We're almost making like the exact opposite. This color. And I'm gonna add a little bit of black in it. A little more. More red. So, using clean water, water that you haven't been dipping your brush in, which is very important, we are going to assume that the light is coming almost like right above it. So, I want my shadow to go around here. So, I'm going to take a little bit of that color. now as these slowly become dry, I'm going to lift off the harsh edges. This one was too wet while I did that, so it just ended up bleeding. So make sure that the areas that you're lifting are sufficiently dry. She might just want to wait until this one is perfectly dry. watching my tutorial. If you like what you see, please support me by liking and subscribing to my channel. You can also find me across Instagram and Facebook at jpomeloart. Thank you for tuning in and happy painting.